light a paper with a matchstick. It burns. You heat milk in a utensil. Eventually, it starts to boil. Stand in the sun for too long and you will feel this, that your skin is heating up. Now, what does this tell us? This tells us that everything around us absorbs heat. And when it does so, the temperature of that object increases. What is different, though, is the speed at which different things absorb heat. Think about it. A paper catches fire quickly. On the other hand, it takes time for water to start boiling, right? This same thing happens with water bodies and land as well. Land and water heat up and cool down at different speeds. Land heats up faster than water. And at the same time, it cools down quickly as compared to water. Let's do a demonstration to understand this. Now, here we have two beakers. In one, you have dry soil, which represents the land. And in another, we have water. Heat both the beakers for 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, you will see that the thermometer shows the temperature of dry soil to be more than the temperature of water. We can conclude from this that equal heat was given to both soil and water. But soil absorbs more heat than water, which is why it warmed up so quickly. Now let's do the opposite. We'll heat soil and water to the same temperature. And then allow them to cool down for 30 minutes. After 30 minutes, you will observe that soil's temperature is much lower than that of water, which means soil loses heat quickly. What does this look like in real life? Let's look at this piece of land which is near the sea. During the day, the sun shines brightly and heats up both the land and water. But from our demonstration earlier, we know that land will heat up faster, right? While the water will heat slowly. This will result in a temperature difference between the land and water. What do you do when you feel very hot and sweaty? You switch on the fan, right? And it cools you down. Now, because of the temperature difference between land and sea, something similar happens. When the land heats up faster, just like you on a hot and sweaty day, a cold sea breeze starts blowing from sea towards land, like a fan. This sea breeze cools the land and brings its temperature down, thus ensuring that the land does not become too hot during the day. Something similar happens during the night. Again, from our second demonstration earlier, we saw that water takes longer to cool down compared to the land, right? So at night, the sea is still warm from all the heat that it absorbed during the day. Now at this time, the land is cooler, and so a cold land breeze will flow towards the sea. Thus, the temperature of both the land and the sea stays comfortable. Thus, we can conclude that when there is a water body around a piece of land, the land experiences moderate climate. It's neither too hot nor too cold. Now, let's take two places, Mumbai and Delhi. Now, you see, Mumbai is near a large water body, which is the Arabian Sea, while Delhi doesn't have any large water body around it, and is surrounded by land masses like Haryana and Uttar Pradesh. In Mumbai, we see the effect of the sea breeze during daytime and the land breeze during the night. Hence, Mumbai has a moderate climate, that is, neither too hot nor too cold. So, it's really comfortable to live near Mumbai. While Delhi has no water body near it, there's no possibility of land or sea breeze here. And so, living in Delhi is not as comfortable as living in Mumbai. This is why distance of a place from the sea plays a huge role in how comfortable that place is going to be.
If you like this video and want to watch many more amazing videos like these, like and subscribe to our channel now.